Hello students, welcome to the class on current affairs. This is 26th class on current affairs. Now, this is part of the promised lecture series in which we will be doing 250 lectures on current affairs for IAS 2019. Plus, these lectures will also help you in 2018 mains. Now, in this class, we'll be discussing a very important development, that is NRC, National Register for Citizenship. Now, this is currently in news. In this class, we'll be understanding its background, and then we'll be understanding what is Assam Accord, and how Assam Accord is related to National Register for Citizenship. And thirdly, we will be understanding the solution for this problem. Now, before we understand National Register for Citizenship, we need to understand the citizenship law in India. Now, agar hum citizenship law ko samajhte hain India mein. Now, citizenship ka ek chapter hai. We have a chapter in our constitution. There, that is, we have part 2 of the constitution. Now, part 2 of the constitution relates to citizenship. This is very important to understand. Now, what does this part 2 of the citizenship say? Now, if you go by the gist of the part 2, it says that the parliament will have the power, parliament will have the authority to make a law on the citizenship. Ki citizen kaun hoga, kaun nahi hoga, this will be decided by the law that will be enacted by the parliament. And accordingly, parliament has enacted Citizenship Act 1955. Now, that act has been amended number of times, keeping into consideration the global changes and the changes in India. Through the changes in the Citizenship Act, we have given citizenship to the people belonging to different regions. So, the Citizenship Act 1955, it has the provisions by which you can become citizenship of India. It also have the provisions by which citizenship can be taken away from you. Now, it is this very act that is the basis of citizenship in India. But presently, what we are discussing is about the National Register of Citizenship. Now, this National Register of Citizenship, it contains the names of the citizens of Assam. Now, this National Register for Citizenship, firstly, it was made in year 1951. Now, presently, in Assam, there are about 3.2 crore people living in Assam. 3.2 crore people. When India got its independence, at that point of time, where we had done this 1951 census, the population was quite less in Assam. But because of the growth of the population in India, and especially in Assam, the population has increased presently to 3.25 crore. But in 1971, in the month of March 1971, there was a lot of influx of the illegal migrants from Bangladesh, because Bangladesh was undergoing war with Pakistan. Bangladesh was earlier called as East Pakistan and Pakistan was called as West Pakistan. So both the countries, both the regions had a war, and Bangladesh got its independence in the month of March in 1971. Because both these countries were undergoing war, lot many people from Bangladesh had migrated to India, and they, most of them, have got themselves settled in Assam. Most of them, not all of them. There had been other regions. West Bengal was also the country where numerous people have been there. But why we are discussing it from just Assam's perspective, the citizenship conflict that has recently emerged. Now, because after 1971, bahut log aake Assam mein settle ho gaya. Jab settle hota hai illegal migrant, to local resources kha jata hai, local employment kha jayega. Is baat ka bahut problem hone lag gaya. Jo local permanent citizens tha Assam ka, India ka, Assam mein rehne wala. To unhone ek movement, they had started a movement against these illegal migrants. There was a lot of conflict. And in 1979, the conflict has taken huge proportions. Conflict had intensified. There were protests, there were processions. There was arson on the road because of the huge pressure of the illegal migrants on the local population of Assam. And because a lot of conflict was created and the situation was very disturbed, this resulted in the conflict between the Assam SMEs student union and with the illegal migrants. So this resulted into a kind of accord between the Union Government of India and the Assamese Student Union. Because students bahut zyada protest karne lag gaye the is cheez ko leke ki jitna illegal migrant, kyunki employment chahiye kisko hota hai, students ko chahiye employment. To unka right hurt ho raha tha. Wo nahi chahte the ki unka right hurt ho, isi wajah se the Assam Student Union ne bahut bada protest launch kar diya. Usko control karne ke liye, an accord was signed between Rajiv Gandhi and between Assam, All India Assam Students Union. Ins union ke saath ek agreement sign ho gaya ki jitne bhi illegal migrants hai unko yahan se nikal diya jayega. And it is under this Assam accord, it was decided that a register will be maintained with respect to the citizenship. Ki kaun Assam ka citizen hai aur kaun citizen nahi hai. To jo 1951 mein National Register for Citizen bana, usko update kiya gaya abhi recently. Now jab update kiya gaya recently, jo present population lagbhag 3 crore se upar ka population hai Assam ka, उसमें से 40 लाख लोग ऐसे हैं जो अपना सिटीजनशिप प्रूव नहीं कर पाए 24th मार्च 1971 से के बाद के पहले का सिटीजनशिप प्रूव कोई रिकॉर्ड नहीं उन लोगों के पास. Now what the present government is mulling, what the present government is thinking about to do, a proposal is on the anvil. मतलब एक प्रपोजल अभी तैयार हो रहा है कि जितना लोग इलीगल माइग्रेंट है उनको अरेस्ट किया जाएगा, डिटेन किया जाएगा, अपनी कंट्री में वापस भेजा जाएगा. नाउ दिस हैज रिजल्टेड इनटू अ बिग ट्रबल बिटवीन बीजेपी एंड द कांग्रेस. एक स्कफल शुरू हो गया है दोनों पार्टीज के बीच में, कांग्रेस और बीजेपी के बीच में. नाउ कांग्रेस इज सेइंग दैट मोस्ट ऑफ दीज इलीगल माइग्रेंट्स, they should, if they don't have, because there will be a section of the poor people who will not be able to prove their identity, because poor people generally they are not literate to have some kind of identity. So Congress ye kar raha hai protest ki gareeb logo ko hata diya jayega India se. BJP keh raha hai ki ye illegal migrants mostly Muslim population ko belong karte hain aur inko nikala jayega. Another very important thing, एक बिल पेंडिंग है पार्लियामेंट में, सिटीजनशिप अमेंडमेंट बिल 2016. वो बिल क्या कहता है? वो बिल कहता है कि जितने भी आसपास के देश हैं हमारे, पाकिस्तान है, बांग्लादेश है, भूटान है, नेपाल है, अफगानिस्तान है, अगर इन देशों में रहने वाले मुस्लिम, सिख, बुद्धिस्ट और जैन अगर चाहें तो वो इंडिया का सिटीजनशिप ले सकते हैं. मुस्लिम्स को अलाउड नहीं किया है उन्होंने. सो व्हाट इट विल मीन, कि 1971 के बाद जितने इंडिया में माइग्रेंट आए हैं इलीगल, चाहे बांग्लादेश से आए हैं, अगर वो हिंदू हैं, सिख हैं, बुद्धिस्ट हैं और जैन हैं, तो उनको सिटीजनशिप मिल सकता है, बट अगर वो मुस्लिम नहीं है तो नहीं मिलेगा। इस बात का भी बहुत प्रॉब्लम हो रहा है असम, ऑल इंडिया असम स्टूडेंट यूनियन को। वो कह रहे हैं कि इनको क्यों देना है, वाई टू डिफ्रेंशिएट ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ रिलीजन। सो दिस इज द एंटायर स्टोरी अबाउट नेशनल रजिस्टर फॉर सिटीजनशिप। अगर कुछ भी समझ नहीं आया, यू कैन कॉन्टैक्ट मी एट 8459400000। Now you can also join our video class packages, plus you can also join our classroom program at Delhi and at Chandigarh, and you can also join our test series for the prelims and for the mains. The mains ka test series hai, bahut intense evaluation kiya jata hai usme, brain IAS mein, aur focus rehta hai ki aapka answer writing skill ko improve karaye. Now brain IAS, it stands for current affairs and it stands for answer writing evaluation, so you can join our classroom program for these things. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice, nice day.